Hello dear friends, welcome to the world of mathematics. It's me Srija Suraj and you are watching SS Math Solutions. In this video, we are going to discuss about the nature of roots. That is, in the last previous video, we discussed about the quadratic equation and its quadratic formula for finding the solution of that quadratic equation. Here, the continuation of that part, here I am discussing about the nature of roots. Okay, when the discriminant is greater than or equal to 0 or less than 0, what happened to the roots? Okay. That we are going to discuss. For that, I am telling a general rule, that is a discriminant. We told that b square minus 4ac. Okay, so this is the condition. If b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, okay, two distinct real roots. Okay, if b square minus 4ac equal to 0, two equal real roots. Okay, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, no real roots. Okay, these are the three cases. That is, our discriminant, we know that the equation x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a is our quadratic formula. Here in the numerator, b square minus 4ac as discriminant. If b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, means that we know that x or the roots or the solution of that quadratic equation have two distinct real roots. If b square minus 4ac equal to 0, means that two equal real roots. That two equal real roots means both are same. B square minus 4ac is less than 0 means no roots. We told that it's containing imaginary numbers or complex. This answer changes to complex solution. Okay. So B square minus 4ac is less than 0 means we can write it as no real roots. Okay. Let's try with some examples. Then you can understand very well. We can check with one example. Okay. 2x square minus 3x plus 5 is equal to 0. Is this a quadratic equation? Yes, surely this is a quadratic equation with the form a square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We can check here only the root exist or not. That is going to check. That is the nature of roots we are going to check. For that, firstly we need the b square minus 4ac. For checking the nature of roots, we need the discriminant only. Okay. So the discriminant, we know that b square minus 4ac. We just to find the value of b square minus 4ac. Here b is minus 3. So minus 3 square minus 4 into a is 2 and c is 5. It's equal to minus 3 square is 9. Minus 4 into 2 is 8, 8, 5 is 40. 9 minus 40 is equal to minus 31. What is the minus 31? Is it less than 0? Yes, surely. So b square minus 4ac is less than 0. The value is less than 0. So we know that according to our condition, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0 means that it has no real roots. So the answer solution we can write, the nature of root is no real roots. This is the solution. If you find ask to find the nature of roots, means that the answer is no real roots. Hope you understood. Now let's try with another one. Another solution is, equation is 3x square minus 4 root 3x plus 4 is equal to 0. Here also we need to find the nature of roots only. So the nature of root is b square minus 4ac. We need to write the discriminant. Here b value is minus 4 root 3. This minus also need to take. So b square is minus 4 root 3 the square minus 4 into a is 3 and c is 4. It's equal to minus 4 root 3 square. 4 square is 16. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. So 16 into 3. 16 into 3 is 48. This minus square. So plus 48. Minus 4 into 3 is 12. 12 into 4 is again 48. So 48 minus 48 is equal to 0. So our b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. So this means that real roots exist. Okay. Real root exist. So 2 equal real root. two equal real roots. Two equal real roots means one solution only, both are equal. That is, the solution is minus b by 2a. This is the solution, minus b by 2a and minus b by 2a. This is no two equal real roots. Minus b by 2a is the solution of this b square minus, sorry, this quadratic equation. Okay, minus b by 2a and minus, so two equal roots. This is the mean. If b square minus 4ac equal to 0, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, no real root. If b square minus 4ac equal to 0, it containing two equal real roots. Now let's take one more equation. 2x square minus 6x plus 3 equal to 0. Okay, again we need to find the discriminant. Discriminant b square minus 4ac is equal to, b value is minus 6. So minus 6 square minus 4 into a is 2 and c is 3. Okay, minus 6 square. Minus 6 square is 36. Minus 4 into 2 is 8. 8 threes are 24. So 36 minus 24 is 12. Surely greater than 0. So greater than 0 means it containing two distinct real roots. We can just find the roots also. So x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This is the solution, right? Okay, just a substitute here. B value is minus of minus 6 plus or minus root of b square. B square means minus 6 square, that is 36, minus 4 into 2 into 3. So 4 into 2 is 8, 8 into 3 is 24, we already found above, divided by 2 into 2. So 36 minus 24, we got 12. So I can write here x is equal to minus of minus 6 is plus 6 plus or minus root of 36 minus 24, we wrote it as root 12 divided by 2 into 2 is 4. So I am writing here 6 plus or minus root 12, I am writing here root 3 into 4 I can write. Isn't it? So this divided by 6 plus or minus 4, root 4 is 2, out, taking outside. So 2 root 3 divided by 4. So the solutions are x is equal to 6 plus 2 root 3 by 4, or x is equal to 6 minus 2 root 3 by 4. Again we can solve this one with a 2. Everywhere 2 is there, we can cancel. Okay, from here 2 gone, 3 will come. Here 2 gone, root 3. Here also 2 gone, 2. So here also similar, 3 minus root 3 by 2. This is the simplest solution. 3 plus root 3 by 2, 3 minus root 3 by 2. Yes, 3 plus root 3 by 2 and x is equal to 3 minus root 3 by 2. These are the nature of quadratic equation once you get. That is, I will tell one more time, b square minus 4ac is less than 0 means that no real root, it contains complex numbers, and b square minus 4ac equal to 0 means it contains two equal real root, and b square minus 4ac is greater than 0 means it contains two distinct real root, that is two roots are different, that is two distinct real root exist. Okay, hope you understood today's video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for future videos.